people. All right, so this morning we're going to be digging some Hugelkultur pits. Maybe in previous videos you've heard me talk about Hugelkultur, Hugelkultur bags. And today I'm going to be attempting to clean up a lot of this brush and debris that's on the ground by burying these logs and branches and even throwing in some wood chips. If I had some composted manure, I would throw that in there too, but I don't have any of that right now, so we're just going to go with the logs and the branches and leaves and just do what we can. So I'll be showing you how to dig a Hugelkultur pit and to use that to not only manage the forest floor, improve the soil, but then to plant in there, and we'll be figuring out what we're going to plant as time goes on. But right now the goal is to finish clearing up this mess, so I'm going to turn this around and let you see where we're going to be concentrating our attention at today. All right, so you'll see that we have a lot of branches and debris right here, and so what I'm going to be doing is digging a large Hugelkultur pit and then burying as much of this debris as I can. I'm going to have to go get my chainsaw and chop some of this up, of course. But the bulk of this, I'm not even going to try to pick it up and haul it away. We're just going to start doing our Hugelkultur beds or Hugelkultur pits and getting rid of a lot of this debris. Okay, here's my first attempt at a Hugelkultur pit. Now, looking at my property, seems like I'm pulling up more vines and roots than anything. You know, this is not as level as I would like it to be, but I'm still a beginner, I'm still learning, but it's deep enough. Looks like it's about 3 feet, 4 feet in some areas. And I could knock out this middle section a little more, but basically, I'm just trying to take these logs right here and chop them up right now. So I brought over the chainsaw and I'm going to put everything inside this pit. And once I put everything inside the pit, I'm going to bury it back with the topsoil and I'm going to wood chip the rest of it. So I am going to start wood chipping this area. And I did get another load of wood chips yesterday. So more wood chips are needed. Much, much more wood chips are needed. But we're gonna just keep doing this and see how it turns out. There's gonna be some mounds in here, but I'm not too worried about that. Like I said, my objective right now is to learn and observe. So this is gonna be a good learning experience. I'm gonna start sawing up these logs and dropping them inside the pit. We'll be right back. right now. I've got to go hydrate. I've been out here for a minute. And I'm sweating bullets, so right now I got to go get some water. Take a break for a minute, and then come back and get at it. It's hot out here, but it's nice and cool under the shade. All right, so break time is over. Let's get you a close up on this pit. So I'm gonna fill this in with some more logs, some more debris, and then we're gonna go get some wood chips, and we're gonna start putting the dirt back on this mound. So I've got enough of the debris in there. I'm gonna try and go get some wood chips now and fill in these spaces so that you don't have a lot of gaps. So as I'm filling it in with wood chips, immediately after that, I'm gonna start digging up the rest of this debris, these twigs and leaves, and I'm gonna start filling it back in. And then lastly, I'm gonna take this sand, I don't even wanna call it dirt at this point, it just all looks like sand, and I'm gonna fill in to make the mound and then cover it with wood chips. So the goal will be to clear this entire boundary by doing this Hugelkultur pits. Okay, so here we go. This is my very first Hugelkultur mound. And I don't know if you can see the steam coming off those fresh wood chips, but that is already hot composting because it was hot composting in the pile that it came from. You can see a lot of fungal material already. So that fungal network is gonna be building up, and this bed is going to hot compost down. It's going to shrink. And I'm telling you, by next spring, there's going to be nothing up under there but good soil. So essentially, We started with a bunch of logs and debris in this area. Now you can see this area is clean, nothing but sandy soil. And the goal is to get all the rest of this debris along the edges and do something similar. Bury it so that we can turn this area into good soil. Now the area that's already cleared, let me just give you a good panoramic view of this area. You'll have to go back to the beginning videos to see how this area started. This is a pretty large area. And when I tell you this area was inaccessible, I mean it was inaccessible to the point that I refused to even walk through here. Okay? Because it was that bad in terms of thick leaves. I mean, it must have been about 8 to 10 inches high worth of leaves in here. just debris all over the place. A lot of trees in here. You can see how many stumps are left behind from the trees that I've cut down. And that's not even including the stumps that I've taken out and gotten rid of and refilled the holes. So this is going to be a lot of work. I would say a good majority of the work is already done. Right now, it's about digging up the rest of these stumps and laying down wood chips across this entire area. Now, where am I going to get these wood chips from? So I get free delivery of wood chips from a local, landscaper or tree person. And every now and then, I get a phone call asking me if I'm ready for more chips. And I say, yes, please bring them. Whether I've used them or not, I know that this job is going to require a lot of chips for me today. I'll have him bring all his wood chips and dump them in this area. So I'll have the whole truckload just dumped right in here. And I'll just come through with the tractor and try to spread them out as much as possible with the bucket. And try to do as little as possible by hand. I'm not trying to do too much work by hand, but if I have to get in here, I have to get in here. But there we go. This is the very first Hugelkultur bed. I may come out here in a little bit, like later on when the sun goes down, and try to smooth this out a little bit. But actually, to tell you the truth, I'm not even worried about smoothing it out because it's going to sink down. It's going to compost down. And I'm not touching this until next spring when I'm ready to start planting either potatoes or a fruit tree or some bushes in this area, because this area is nice for exactly that. All right, it's got a little bit of shade. It's got, I should say, I'll just describe it as partial shade. That means it gets some sun and it gets quite a bit of shade as well. But this area is perfect for some strawberries or blueberries. All right, and like I said, this mound is large enough that I can also plant potatoes in this thing. So as this composts down, it's gonna look real nice next year. We'll be right back.